Guys, I am Pankaj and I welcome you all to the session in which we will be taking up 25 questions of SSC JE 2018 Mechanical Engineering 25th September Shift 2. Okay. So let us start. The head loss due to the friction in a pipe of length 9.81 meters. And how much is the diameter given? So diameter is 1 meter. And velocity of water is 2 meter per second and friction factor is 0.06. So HF will be equal to 4FLV square divided by 2GD. So when you substitute all these values, you will get D is equal to 0.12 meters. So the right answer is D. So the next question is a downward vertical load of 10 kilonewton is acting. So here you can see that C point pe 10 kilonewton ka ek force hai. Point A, point B. So point A or point C ki beech ka jo gap hai, that is 0.4 meters. Point C or point B ka jo gap hai, that is 0.6 meters. So when you apply moment equation about point B, so when we find out the moment of all the forces acting on this beam about point B and putting all these values to zero, so aapko jo equation milega, that will be equal to Ra into 1 is equal to 10 into 0.6, and finally the reaction at point A will be equal to 6 kilo Newton. Okay, so the next question, which of the following is not correct in regard of economizer? So there is a difference between economizer and superheater. So the basic purpose of superheater is to increase the heat energy of water in such a way that the steam gets converted into superheated steam, whereas economizer is something which is placed before boiler so that the feed water temperature increases. So kya hoga ki aapka jo boiler hai usse pehle aap economizer lagayenge, theek hai, aur economizer ke baad aapka boiler hoga. To boiler mein jo feed water jane wala hai, to aap yahan pe jo waste flue gases hain, so by utilizing all waste flue gases, you will be supplying the waste flue gases to this economizer, and in this economizer there will be some water, and when this waste flue gases is supplied to the economizer, the temperature of the water will increase and this water is being fed to the boiler. So finally kya hoga ki boiler mein jo aapko actual amount of heat supply karni padegi, that will get reduced. So in this case, which of the following is not correct? So the right answer is C. So it will not change the phase. Economizer is not meant to change the phase, but it is meant to increase the temperature of the feed water. Okay, next question. What is the effect on reducing the evaporating pressure? So you can clearly see that here the evaporating effect is given on this line, okay, which is equal to H1 minus H4. When you reduce this pressure in such a way that you get a new point H4 dash and H1 dash, so the new enthalpy difference will be equal to H1 dash minus H4 dash. So these enthalpy differences are nothing but the evaporating or refrigerating effect or cooling effect. So you can clearly see that H1 minus H4 is basically greater than the value of H1 dash minus H4 dash. It means that the basic purpose or the effect of reducing the evaporator pressure is that there will be decrease in evaporating effect or cooling effect. So in this case, the right answer is B. Okay, so the next question is the measurement of temperature, flow rate and CO and CO2 content in a boiler chimney gases helps one to calculate. So isme se aapko find out karna hai ki which of the following is incorrect statement. Okay, so it can help you to find out the heat amount of flue gases. It can also help you to find out the possibility of condensation of moisture in flue gases line, and as well as it can help you to find out the energy lost by the partial combustion of fuel, because whenever there is incomplete combustion of fuel, there will be generation of carbon monoxide, hydrogen, carbon dioxide and such other hydrocarbons. Okay, so in this case D is the incorrect answer, which is loss due to incomplete combustion of fuel on grate. So, ye thoda sa dicey option hai, doubtful option hai, and therefore option D is incorrect. Okay, the next question is, identify the incorrect statement from the following option. So we know that in case of air refrigeration cycle, the medium being used is air, and it is based on reversed Brayton cycle. Sometimes it is also called as Bell-Coleman cycle. And the stages which are involved in air cycle is basically, or the reverse Brayton cycle is basically, it has two constant pressure process and two isentropic stages. Okay, so it will not have any isochoric or constant volume stages. So in this case, the incorrect answer will be A. Heat rejection and heat removal from the cooled space are constant volume process. Okay, next question, 107. Identify the incorrect statement from the following option. Steels are ferrous alloys. Yes, steels are the ferrous alloys. So steel are the ferrous alloys which has carbon as an alloying element, or carbon ke alawa bhi bahut sare alloying element ho sakte hain. So it is a valid statement. So option A to sahi hai ki carbon ke alawa bhi baki ke alloying elements aapke steel mein present ho sakte hain. It has less than 2.14% of carbon. Yes, it is also correct. It has less than 2.14% of carbon. This is also correct. Option C, with higher strength due to the alloying of carbon. Hai na, agar aap carbon ke saath alloying karenge, so there will be increase in strength. So option C is also correct. But steel will not have higher ductility. Okay. And at least it will not have higher ductility due to the presence of carbon. Higher ductility ho sakti hai, but baki kisi alloying element ki wajah se, not due to carbon. So in this case, D is the incorrect answer. So D is the right answer for 107. Okay, next question. Identify the incorrect statement from the following options for the given statements. Okay, so we need to find out the incorrect statement. So aapne dekha hoga ki bahut sare questions aise hain jahan pe aapse pucha gaya hai ki which of the following is incorrect statement. To thoda sa 25th September second shift ka jo paper hai, it was a bit confusing paper. Agar aapne upar dhyan se nahi padha hai ki aapko kya pucha hai, whether it is correct or incorrect, to ho sakta hai ki aapke answers galat ho jaye. Okay, so whenever you have superheated steam in Rankine cycle, it will not have any effect on pumping work, hai na. Agar aap dhyan se dekhenge TS plot, so this is TS plot. So 1-2-2 is basically a process which is taking place in steam turbine. It is expansion, it is isentropic expansion, and after that there will be condensation. Complete condensation of wet steam will take place, and you will get 0.3, or 0.3 se upar aapka ek pump work hoga, and then from 4 to 1 there will be heat addition. Okay, now agar aap superheating karenge, let us say aapne 1 ko thoda sa aur heat kiya, and let us say you get 1 dash. So agar aap superheating karenge, so you can see that there can be change in work output. Q, because work output is nothing but WT minus WP. So we know that WT will increase, and when WT will increase, there will be change in, or positive change in net work output. But it is quite evident from this figure that there will not be any change in pump work. So therefore, in this case, the right answer is D. Okay, so the next question, we need to find out the absolute velocity at 6 seconds. So T is equal to 6 seconds pe aapko velocity find out karni hai, which is equal to under root of Vx square plus Vy square. Hai na? अब यहां पे Vx क्या होगा, Vx will be equal to dx by dt, and when you differentiate it, you will get 4 meter per second, whereas minus 9 meter per second, whereas when you find out Vy, it will be equal to d by dt of dy by dt. So dt square by dt. So you will get 2t. Okay. So here we will get minus 9 square plus 2t square. Now how much is time? Time is 6 seconds. So 9 square plus 12 square, you will get 15 meter per second. So the right answer is C. Okay. So the next question is, mercury is a suitable fluid for a barometer because it has a low pressure at room temperature. Because kyun hoga aisa? Because adhesive forces in mercury are more than the cohesive forces, and therefore it will have low vapor pressure. So C is the right answer. Okay, so the next question is, there is a 500 kg of heat which is removed from a cooled space in a reversed Carnot cycle by an evaporator by refrigerant at minus 23 degrees Celsius. How much will be the change in entropy of the refrigerant? है ना? तो आप यहाँ पे आपसे पूछा गया कि entropy कितना change होगा? Now, if I ask you, what is the total change in entropy of the refrigerator? So you will say that for any Carnot based devices, the total change in entropy will be equal to zero. ठीक है? But यहाँ पे आपसे पूछा है कि when you are removing heat from a reservoir which is maintained at minus 23 degrees Celsius, which is indeed 250 degrees Kelvin, so how much will be the change in entropy of the refrigerant? Okay, तो जब आप 250 Kelvin के reservoir से heat को remove करोगे, तब change in entropy कितना होगा? So that will be given by dS is equal to dQ by T. Okay, now how much heat is being removed? It is 500 kilojoule. Okay, और temperature कितना है? Temperature will be equal to 250. So we will get 2 kilojoule per Kelvin. Okay, so this will be the answer, 2 kilojoule per Kelvin. So C is the right answer. Okay, now in this question, 500 kilojoule of heat is removed from a cooled space in a reverse Carnot by an evaporator by refrigerant, the change in entropy of the refrigerant. So the change in entropy of the refrigerant. So if you talk about the reservoir, then the change in entropy will be negative. But when you talk about the refrigerant, which is basically a system in which the heat is being added, so whenever heat is being added to any system, in that case, the change in entropy will be positive. And therefore, we are supposed to take a positive value 2. So, yahan pe aapke paas minus 2 bhi hai, 2 bhi hai, to confuse nahi hona hai. Yahan pe 2 kis liye hai? Because heat is being added to the refrigerant. Okay, so let us move on to the next question. A pipe of diameter 10 cm carrying water at 5 meter per second reduces into a small diameter of 5 cm. How much will be the velocity in the small diameter section? Okay, so yahan pe agar aap dhyan se dekhen, so this will be 10 cm. Here it will be 5 cm. So in this case, you can apply the continuity equation, which says that the mass flow rate remains constant. And mass flow rate at section 1 and at section 2 will be constant, and then rho 1 a1 v1 will be equal to rho 2 a2 v2. So rho 1 a1 v1 is equal to rho 2 a2 into v2. But in such question, you are supposed to assume that the density is going to be constant or the flow is incompressible. So whenever the flow is incompressible, so a1 v1 is equal to a2 v2. So जब आप क्वेश्चन को सॉल्व करेंगे फाइनली, सो यू विल बी गेटिंग v2 इज इक्वल टू 20 मीटर पर सेकेंड. सो इन दिस केस द राइट आंसर इज बी. ओके, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. तो वापस आपसे वही पूछा है कि इनमें से कौन सा इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट है. सो इंडस्ट्रियल स्टीम जनरेटर्स दैट आर यूज्ड इन शुगर एंड पेपर इंडस्ट्रीज और हॉस्पिटल्स. सो इन दिस केस, इन दिस क्वेश्चन, the incorrect option is A, which says that it can operate with fluidized bed combustor using bales of gases. So this is basically an incorrect statement. So basically, it can be bed units for coal or rice husk, or it could have coal fired, or it could have coal or wood fired. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे आप baggers का इस्तेमाल नहीं करेंगे, so you cannot use baggers, and therefore the option A is incorrect. Okay, so the next question is 1 ton of refrigeration. So 1 ton of refrigeration, this is by definition. So 1 ton of refrigeration is given by 210 kilojoule per minute, and in terms of kilowatt, it will be 3.5 kilowatt. So in this case, the right answer is B. Okay, so the next question is, it says that there is a pipe, horizontal pipe, which carries water flowing at a velocity of 10 meter per second. The static pressure gauge reading at its inlet and outlet are how much? 3 and 2.6 kgf per centimeter square. So how much would be the head loss? Okay, so it means that at the inlet, the static pressure was 3 kgf per centimeter square, but at the exit, it became 2.6 kgf per centimeter square. So it means that there is a loss of pressure, which is nothing but the difference between these two quantities, 3 minus 2.6. So it means that 0.4 kgf per centimeter square. But you are supposed to find out this quantity in terms of water. So this 0.4 will be multiplied with g and into 10 to the power 4, and it will be divided by rho g, because we know that delta p is equal to rho g h, or p is equal to rho g h. So you want to find out delta p in terms of meter of water. So what you can do is you can write h is equal to delta p divided by rho g. So delta p should be in terms of newton per meter square. So 0.4 into 9.81 into 10 to the power 4, because when you convert centimeter square in terms of meter square, you are supposed to multiply this unit by 10 to the power 4, and it will be divided by 9.81, which is the quantity of g, and the density is density of water is how much? It is 1000. So when you divide this quantity by 9.81 and 1000, so you'll be getting the answer as 4 meter of water. So the right answer is B. Okay, so the coefficient of discharge for an actual orifice meter. So yahan pe kya, you are supposed to compare orifice meter with venturi meter. Okay, now the value of coefficient of discharge of orifice meter is basically less than the coefficient of discharge for venturi meter. Aisa kyun? Because in case of orifice meter, there will be discharge losses, and whenever there is loss in discharge or loss in discharge, in that case there will be less discharge quantity, and therefore coefficient of discharge will be less in case of orifice meter. But in case of venturi meter, the discharge quantity will be more, because there will be less loss in discharge, and therefore you can say that CD of orifice meter will be less than CD of venturi meter. So C is the right answer. Okay, so again we need to find out incorrect option, hai na? Yahan pe aapko correct nahi, incorrect find out karna hai. So whenever you apply first law of thermodynamics, it says that cyclic integral of del Q is equal to cyclic integral of del W. Okay, this is for cycle. For the process, del Q is equal to du plus del W. Okay, so it means that ki ye do cheeze to hongi. Okay, now agar dekhen, option A, efficiency of cycle is given by net work done to the heat supplied. It means that this option is correct. Then net work done will be given by QH minus QL, which is also correct. Ye bhi sahi hai. And the C option, which is indeed the statement for first law of thermodynamics. So C is also correct. But as you see, the option D is given, which is given as Q1 by QH, which is wrong. It is supposed to be W net or QH minus QL. अगर क्यू एच माइनस क्यू एल होता या फिर डब्ल्यू नेट होता तो ऑप्शन डी सही हो सकता था, बट इन दिस केस द इनकरेक्ट आंसर इज डी. ओके, सो द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट फॉर डीजल साइकिल वेन एवर देर इज इंक्रीज इन कट ऑफ रेशियो. सो हियर वी हैव टेकन द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर एफिशियंसी. ओके, तो यहां पे आप देख सकते हैं कि मैंने एफिशियंसी का इक्वेशन लिया है, वेयर गामा इज नथिंग बट द एडियाबेटिक इंडेक्स विच इज 1.4, वेयर एज आर इज कंप्रेशन रेशियो. कंप्रेशन रेशियो, सो व्हाट इज कंप्रेशन रेशियो? इट इज द रेशियो ऑफ वॉल्यूम बिफोर कंप्रेशन टू द वॉल्यूम आफ्टर कंप्रेशन, एंड इट इज ऑलवेज मोर देन 1. वेयर एज व्हाट इज आर सी? आर सी इज नथिंग बट कट ऑफ रेशियो. इट इज कट ऑफ रेशियो. सो हाउ विल यू डिफाइन कट ऑफ रेशियो? सो कट ऑफ रेशियो इज द रेशियो ऑफ वॉल्यूम आफ्टर कट ऑफ टू द वॉल्यूम बिफोर कट ऑफ, एंड दिस वैल्यू इज ऑल्सो मोर देन 1. सो बोथ कंप्रेशन रेशियो एंड कट ऑफ रेशियो वैल्यूज आर मोर देन 1. नाउ व्हेन यू इंक्रीज कट ऑफ रेशियो, सो यू कैन सी दैट यू हैव आर सी टू द पावर 1.4 माइनस 1 डिवाइडेड बाई आर सी टू आर सी माइनस 1, एंड अदर पैरामीटर्स आर सपोज टू बी कॉन्स्टेंट. सो व्हेन यू इंक्रीज आर सी तो क्या होगा? आपका न्यूमरेटर और डिनोमिनेटर दोनों इंक्रीज होगा, बट द रेट ऑफ इंक्रीज इन न्यूमरेटर विल बी मोर एज कंपेयर टू द रेट ऑफ इंक्रीज इन डिनोमिनेटर, एंड द ओवरऑल इफेक्ट ऑफ दिस टर्म विच इज बींग सर्कल्ड इट विल बी इंक्रीजिंग. सो इट विल इंक्रीज. सो वेन दिस वैल्यू विल इंक्रीज इट मीन्स दैट द एफिशियंसी ऑफ साइकिल विल डिक्रीज. ओके, सो हियर इन दिस ऑप्शन डी इट इज गिवन दैट इट इंक्रीजेज द थर्मल एफिशियंसी विच इज इन फैक्ट अ रॉन्ग स्टेटमेंट बिकॉज इट विल डिक्रीज द थर्मल एफिशियंसी. ओके, तो यहां पर हमने देख भी लिया है कि किस तरीके से आपका थर्मल एफिशियंसी का जो टर्म है इट विल डिक्रीज. सो फॉर 118 द राइट आंसर इज डी. ओके, सो द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, द स्पेसिफिक एंथैल्पीज ऑफ रेफ्रिजरेंट इन अ वेपर कंप्रेशन सिस्टम आर गिवन. सो लेट अस ड्रॉ द फिगर फॉर पीएच. ओके, let us say this is 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1 to 2 is compression, 2 to 3 is condensation, 3 to 4 is expansion in capillary tube, and 4 to 1 is the cooling effect which is taking place in evaporator. So COP is given by refrigerating effect divided by work consumed in compression. Okay, because there will not be any work consumption in case of capillary tube where expansion is taking place. Okay, so refrigerating effect is nothing but H1 minus H4, whereas W compression is H2 minus H1. So how much is H1? H1 is given by 1200 kilojoule per kg, whereas H4 is given as 100 kilojoule per kg. H2, which is nothing but the value of enthalpy after compression, it is given as 1300 kilojoule per kg minus 1200. So when you divide this quantity, you will get 11. It means that the COP value will be equal to D. Okay, so the next question is 120. Which of the following is possible according to the second law of thermodynamics? So if you see, it has been asked which one is possible. So let us start with option D. Option D se start karte hain, and we'll see ki isme se kaun sa statement sahi hai aur kaun sa statement galat hai. So according to the second law of thermodynamics, if you talk about Kelvin Planck statement, which says that it is impossible to construct a device which is operating in a cycle in such a way that it could convert the heat into work into equal amount of work at same temperature or wherever this type of device will be interacting with single temperature reservoir. Whereas the Clausius statement says that it is impossible to flow the heat from low temperature to high temperature without any external work input. Okay, so these are the statements of second law of thermodynamics. Now, इसमें से पूछा है कि इसमें से कौन सा possible है? So let us start with option D. 100% conversion of quantity of heat into work, which is Kelvin Planck statement. उसने क्या कहा कि कभी भी आप 100% of heat को work में convert नहीं कर सकते. And such a device is also called as PMM2, which is not possible according to second law of thermodynamics. It means that option D is not possible. Then spontaneous compression of gas without any external work. So it means that you are trying to compress the gas without supplying any work from outside, which is indeed, or which is in fact a wrong statement, which is not possible. So whenever you want to compress a gas, whenever you want to reduce the volume, so whenever you want to reduce the volume, you are supposed to apply some work from outside, okay? Because work is given by PdV. So agar aap volume change kar rahe hain, so there has to be some work output of, I would say, the supply of work from outside, okay? So it means that option C is wrong. Then spontaneous flow of heat from cold to hot body, which is nothing but Clausius statement. So ye bhi possible nahi hoga. So it means that option D, option C, option B possible nahi hai. So we are left with option A, which says that a perpetual frictionless pendulum, jo ki possible hai. Agar aap koshish karenge to ek frictionless pendulum possible ho sakta hai, and therefore according to second law of thermodynamics, option A is correct. Agar is question ko dhyan se dekha jaye, so any device cannot be, you know, koi bhi device le lijiye aap, usme friction hoga, है ना. it is a you know by nature. तो अगर by nature friction होगा तो इस केस में मैंने ऑप्शन ए क्यों लिया है. मैंने ऑप्शन ए इसलिए लिया है बिकॉज यहां पे ऑप्शन डी, ऑप्शन सी, ऑप्शन बी मुझे 100% कंफर्म है कि गलत है. अब हो सकता है कि ऑप्शन ए के लिए मैं कंफ्यूज हूं कि ऑप्शन ए सही है या गलत है, बट अगर ऑप्शन डी, ऑप्शन बी, ऑप्शन सी सही नहीं है, इसका मतलब कि ऑप्शन ए आंसर हो सकता है. तो कई बार क्या होता है कि जब भी स्टाफ सिलेक्शन कमीशन कुछ क्वेश्चंस को सेट करता है तो कुछ ऑप्शंस हो सकते हैं कि गलत हो. हो सकता है कि ऑप्शन ए यहां पे गलत हो, बट ऑप्शन ए सेकंड लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स के हिसाब से गलत नहीं है. ठीक है, अगर फ्रिक्शन की बात आ रही है तो ये किसी और लॉ को वैलिडेट नहीं कर रहा होगा, बट एटलीस्ट इट इज वैलिडेटिंग सेकंड लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स, एंड देयरफॉर आई हैव टेकन ऑप्शन ए एज द आंसर. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट brake efficiency, which is given by 3600 divided by BSFC into calorific value. So what is BSFC? BSFC is brake specific fuel consumption, and it is given how much? It is given 200 grams, so which means that it is 0.2 kg per kilowatt hour. And calorific value is how much? It is given as 40 mega joule per kg. So when you substitute these values, you will get brake efficiency as 45%. Okay, so the next question is, हाँ यही वो question जो हम बात कर रहे थे पहले कि अगर system से if I'm talking about system, अगर system से heat का rejection होता है, so in that case the change in entropy of the system will be negative. But if heat is being added to the system, in that case the change in entropy of the system will be positive. ठीक है, समझ में आ गया. अब यहां पे we need to find out change in entropy. So change in entropy is given by ds is equal to dq by t. So how much is the temperature? Temperature is 800 Kelvin, and the heat which is being rejected by the system to the surrounding. So it means that the flow of heat is from system to surrounding, and therefore it is taken as negative. So how much? Minus of 1 kilojoule per Kelvin. So therefore we will get minus of 1.25 joule per Kelvin. ठीक है, so this is the answer in case of 122. Okay, next question. The enthalpies of feed water and steam at exit of a boiler are how much? 73 and 2800. Steam output is how much? It is 1128.5 kg per hour. How much will be the equivalent evaporation? So what is equivalent evaporation? Equivalent evaporation is nothing but it is the mass flow rate in terms of kg per hour at which the water will be vaporizing in a given steam boiler if it is supplied and evaporated at normal boiling point and normal atmospheric conditions. So, agar aapka normal atmospheric condition, let us say 1 atmospheric pressure hai aur boiling let us say 100 degree Celsius hai, to 100 degree Celsius pe kitna steam formation hoga in terms of kg per hour if the water or if the temperature of feed water is 100 degree Celsius and it is also being evaporated at 100 degree Celsius. So in such a case, such type of evaporation or the generation of steam in kg per hour, it will be called as equivalent evaporation, and it is given by mass flow rate of steam multiplied by the difference of enthalpies at the inlet of boiler and at the exit of boiler. So at the exit of boiler, the enthalpy will be more because you will be supplying some heat to the boiler, whereas the enthalpy at the inlet will be less, okay, and it will be divided by 2258. So what is 2258? It is basically enthalpy of evaporation of water at 100 degree Celsius. So when you substitute all these values, you will get 1363.5 kg per hour. So it's a nice question, it's a good question. So wherein you have been asked about equivalent evaporation. So option A is correct. Okay, so next question is based on impulse turbine. So what is impulse turbine? Impulse turbine is a turbine in which there is no reaction. Okay, so whatever work output you'll be getting, it is due to the change in kinetic energy and it is not due to the change in pressure. Okay, now whenever you use impulse turbine, देखिए जब भी आप impulse turbine use करेंगे, अगर मैं बात करूँ basic impulse turbine की, जो बहुत पहले the first type of impulse turbine, वहाँ पे जो basic issue था वो ये था कि the velocity or I would say the change in kinetic energy, it was so huge that the velocity of blade was quite high. Okay, तो blade की जो rotational speed थी, it was like way high. और इतना ज़्यादा था कि कहीं ना कहीं उससे कुछ न कुछ इश्यूज आने लगे. ओके, क्या इश्यूज आने लगे वो हम बाद में देखेंगे. अब यहाँ पे ड्यू टू द हाई रोटेशनल स्पीड, इफ यू हैव सम प्रॉब्लम, सो व्हाट आर द रेमेडीज फॉर दैट? सो व्हाट यू कैन डू इज यू कैन यूज टू टाइप ऑफ मेथड्स इन ऑर्डर टू इंक्रीज द रोटेशनल स्पीड ऑफ इम्पल्स टर्बाइन. ओके, द फर्स्ट मेथड इज velocity compounding and second option is the pressure compounding. So the compounding effect is nothing but to decrease the rotational speed of blades. Okay, so now we have been asked the velocity compounded impulse turbine will have. So it will have a nozzle, a moving blade and a fixed blade. So it is going to consist of one set of nozzles followed by stages of alternate set of moving and fixed blade. So in this case, the right answer is D. Okay, so the last question is, a pump has a delivery head of 75 meter water. Which of the following can be convenient method for measuring the pressure? So it means that if you have 75 meter of water, so it's a huge pressure. Okay, so when you convert this in terms of pressure, rho g h, so rho is how much? It is 1000. The value of g is 9.81 and h is 75. Okay, तो इतना ज़्यादा value होगा. It is approximately, अगर मैं इसको 10 assume कर लूँ, so it will be 75 into 10 to the power 4 newton per meter square. Okay, so it means that it is almost 750 kilopascal. And the devices which are given in these four options, piezometer, pitot tube, सिंगल कॉलम मैनोमीटर विथ मर्करी, देखिए पिटोट ट्यूब तो करेगा नहीं. ओके, वेयर इज पीजोमीटर एंड सिंगल कॉलम मैनोमीटर आर मेंट फॉर लो प्रेशर. ओके, सो इट मींस दैट द बॉर्डन गेज कैन मेजर सच हाई प्रेशर्स एंड इट कैन मेजर अप टू 700 मेगा पास्कल. ओके, सो इन दिस केस द राइट आंसर इज डी. ओके, सो दिस इज ऑल इन दिस सेशन. वी हैव टेकन फर्स्ट 25 क्वेश्चंस ऑफ 25th सितंबर सेकेंड शिफ्ट एंड आई होप आपको ये सेशन पसंद आया होगा. एंड इसी के साथ इसका जो पीडीएफ होगा वो भी अपलोड कर दिया जाएगा And all the best, guys, for your forthcoming exams. Thank you.